Welcome to CricNuts, cricket recaps and insights.
Welcome to the MLC Junior Labor Day 2023, Under 16 Division A. The Seattle Sonics and the TCL Trophy Fighters locked horns in a thrilling encounter that had us all on the edge of our seats. The Sonics, known for their batting prowess, were up against the Fighters, who have a reputation for their lethal bowling attack.
Absolutely, Ravish. The stage was set for a classic showdown. The sun was shining, the pitch was perfect, and the crowd was buzzing with anticipation. It was the perfect setting for a cricket carnival.
We must acknowledge our event advertisers who made this thrilling match possible. Their support has been instrumental in promoting junior cricket and giving these young talents a platform to showcase their skills.
Indeed, Ravish. And speaking of support, let us not forget Top Cricket Store. They have been championing cricket across key states. Do not forget to use the code CricNuts20OFF to enjoy $20 off on your purchases above $200.
The match was a tale of two halves. The Sonics batted first and put up a competitive total of 204 runs. The Fighters, despite their best efforts, were unable to chase down the target, succumbing to the Sonics' bowling attack.
Yes, Ravish. The Sonics' batting performance, coupled with their disciplined bowling, proved too much for the Fighters. The turning point was undoubtedly the early fall of wickets in the Fighters' innings, which derailed their chase.
The first innings was a masterclass in batting from the Sonics. Raghav Satish's 68 off 78 balls was the highlight, but the partnership between him and Shrikar Nemani, which added 111 runs, laid the foundation for the Sonics' total.
Absolutely, Ravish. The Sonics' strategy of steady batting and building partnerships worked wonders. The Fighters' bowlers, despite their best efforts, could not break the momentum, although Manan Taylor and Kahan Sarkarwala's bowling spells deserve a mention.
The second innings was a different story altogether. The Sonics bowlers, led by Sanshwe Cherukumili, tore through the Fighters' batting lineup. The Fighters' top scorer, Omkar Mohile, could only manage 16 runs, reflecting the dominance of the Sonics' bowling attack.
The Sonics' bowlers indeed turned the match on its head. The Fighters' batsmen just could not cope with the relentless pressure. The early wickets, especially the fall of the top order within the first 10 overs, was a significant turning point.
Raghav Satish, with his top-scoring innings, and Sanshwe Cherukumili, with his devastating bowling spell, were the standout performers for the Sonics. Their performances were instrumental in shaping the match's outcome.
Absolutely, Ravish. On the Fighters' side, Manan Taylor's bowling performance deserves a mention. His three wickets were crucial in keeping the Sonics' total in check. However, the lack of support from the other bowlers and the batting collapse overshadowed his efforts.
The Seattle Sonics emerged victorious, winning by a massive margin of 148 runs. Their superior batting and bowling performances proved too much for the TCL Trophy Fighters.
It was indeed a comprehensive victory for the Sonics. The Fighters will surely be looking to regroup and come back stronger in their next match. This match was a testament to the Sonics' all-round performance. Their strategy of building partnerships while batting and maintaining pressure while bowling worked perfectly. The Fighters, on the other hand, will need to work on their batting if they are to bounce back.
Indeed, Lily, this match will be remembered for the Sonics' dominance and the Fighters' fighting spirit. It sets the stage for an exciting season ahead. Until next time, it is goodbye from us.